Welcome back. Well, throughout the COVID-19 pandemic, many people are facing challenges, which are stressful as well as overwhelming. They lead to a long range of health problems, including heart disease, diabetes, depression, and anxiety. Now, learning to cope with stress in a healthy way will make you, the people you care about, and those around you be more resilient. Joining us and sharing more about this is the plant-based nutrition health coach and the owner of CB Health and Wellness, Dr. Cecilia Baspas. And Dr. Baspas, good to have you back.
I'm happy to be back with you guys, Darren. It's great to see you again.
Good to see you. And as we talk about, you know, seeing each other, obviously we haven't seen each other a lot because of the COVID-19 pandemic, and with people staying home. And a part of staying home is sometimes doing some unhealthy things, like eating. And so I want you to talk for a little bit about stress eating and what that looks like and what that sounds like.
Well, stress eating is usually triggered by, like the word says, stress. And now with COVID, it's happening that a lot. Also with boredom. And also when you don't have, when you have a lack of physical activity, right? And there's a lot of emotions and things going on in your mind, and there's not a lot of like energy released through your body, right? So when all those things happen, you start eating, right? And also when you are stressed, one of the ways of coping that stress is like having an instant gratification. So instant gratification comes with sometimes sweets, sometimes salty things, and usually carbs. So those are the things that usually people try to like pick, and then they start eating without any control.
Yeah. So what are some of the side effects of stress or direct effects of stress? Because while people are out there stressing, I don't think that many times we all think about some of the direct effects the stress causes when it's not checked.
Well, the effects of stress could be, I mean, could affect all your body, complete body, right? It could go from digestive problems. It could go, also could happen that your sleep is altered. So there's not a lot, there's not a good sleep. There's also could be mood changes. There could be stress also takes you for, it's not that it takes you, it just gives you, it produces a low immune system. Your immune system starts to go low, right? So when that happens, you can catch a lot of, you can have a lot of illnesses like the flu or COVID if you're around it. And also there could be other things that stress could give you heart problems, could give you high blood pressure. It could take you, especially like heart issues, could like malfunctioning of your heart and stuff like that.
Walk me through a little bit of the natural remedies that are available to deal. And I know this is your area of expertise. So share with us a little bit about those natural remedies that can actually help somebody.
To help you like survive with stress. I mean, one of the things about stress and also like stress eating and everything is, I think one of the first things that you have to do is really realize what's happening in your life, right? If you're really, some people don't know that they're stressed at this moment. They have this anxiety, but they don't know what it is, right? Or they've been inside and they've been coping with COVID for so long that they don't really know what's going on. But so like have a small, you know, on a piece of paper, write down what happened. Do a diary of what you've been eating all day, for example, right? So then you can see like if you've been eating, overeating, right? Also, take some time to do some exercise. Go outside, just be outside, like have some fresh air. Do your walks. Also have a watch or even like on your phone, have an app that says a Fit app, right? And start counting your steps or, you know, put like, let your phone say, okay, after a couple of hours, give you like an alert of, you know, you should like stand up, do some exercise and stuff like that. Also, with COVID and when you've been like working from home, it's just like it gives you, you're supposed to work more because you're from home, right? You cannot like take a break. You're like, you have to be 24/7 available, right? So just put on your calendar, I don't know, from like 12:30 to 1, I'm going to give myself half an hour, I'm going to go outside. I'm going to prepare my meal. It's the same time that you will take when you're at work, right? You will just take half an hour or an hour, just go get your meal, come back. So, but when you're at home, you don't do that. You don't take time. You don't take time to just go get a coffee. You don't take time to walk. You don't go to the subway or stuff like that. So take some time for yourself. And also during the week, I would also like always suggest to like have like a date with yourself. Do something that you really enjoy, something that you, like gives you pleasure. I usually say, I call it like dates with Cecilia. For me, it's to go outside or maybe go hiking or take the dog and a walk in a green area. So that gives you me peace and also makes me relax a little bit. And also you do the exercise, right? Because you'll be walking a lot. The other thing is do not buy things that you don't want to eat, right? I mean, when you go to the supermarket and you have all your chips and stuff like that, you definitely want to eat that at the moment. But then when you're at home and you have all your sweets and all your like chips and all the things that are not good for you, just don't buy them. Avoid having them at home and also have like healthy snacks at home. Just get some of that and like always have them. For example, have like little carrots in your refrigerator. Some have some hummus, have some celery that it's already cut and clean and stuff like that. So when you're like hungry, you just open the fridge because we usually do that. We open the fridge and we're like, okay, so what are we going to eat now? And then have those things available. So when you eat, then you have those and then you have a good choice of what you're going to eat.
We only have just about a minute left, but I wanted to ask you before we go, what are some of the major causes of stress? Because we find now that one in 10 individuals pretty much suffer from stress.
Mm-hmm. What are the causes of stress? I feel like a lot of the stress is, it's being given by a situation of things that you need to do. Like people are like asking you to do a lot of things. And also as human beings, we are autocritical of ourselves, right? We never do things the way we're supposed to do. So it's like, we're always like criticizing ourselves. And then that gives us also a lot of stress for us. Cause if our goal is of how we're gonna do things are like up here and we can do here, then there's always failure, right? And then with that, you know, you're always criticizing yourself and that gives you more stress. And also the idea of not being able to be outside with other people. Well, right now here we can go a little bit, but in other countries we can. Or also like be able to get together with people, with friends. That gives you stress.
Dr. Vasquez, thank you so much for being with us, sharing a little bit about stress and some natural ways that we can actually make some more healthier choices. Thank you for being with us.
Thank you for like having me. It's always a pleasure.
Yes. Well, if you want more information, please visit her website at ceciliabaspis.com. You can always call 646-427-2584. Again, that number 646-427-2584. We encourage you, don't go anywhere. We've got more Open coming up right after.